In this video, let's find out Spider-Man Far From Home movie's second revenge, the Elementals. Hey, what's up, Nerdian? This is Abhishek Nathia, and welcome into the Dub Comics channel, where we dub comic book series that have been inspiring Hollywood filmmakers and TV producers to create superhero movies and TV shows based on our beloved superhero characters and our storylines. In today's video, we'll find out the first appearance and the origin story of the Elementals into the comic books. According to Marvel and Sony, these characters are supposed to be Hydro Man, Molten Man, Sandman, and I don't know who the fourth one is. Or is it the Elemental Zord, where they will combine together to fight against Spidey in the third act? Maybe. But most of us already know that it's the Mysterious Illusions or the Elementals themselves. Spider-Man and X-Men fans already know who Mysterio is and what he is capable of. But if you don't, then you can check out our last video on Mysterio's origin and first appearance by clicking here, or check out the description below. So without further ado, let's start our today's video.
Supernatural thrillers featuring the Living Mummy. He stalks two worlds. Stanley presents The Living Mummy, written by Tony Isabella. Artist Val Merrick, lettering by Tom Orzechowski, coloring by Glenys Wayne, editor Roy Thomas. 3,000 years ago, he was an Kantu, warrior king who freed his people from the yoke of the Pharaoh, for which crime he was sentenced to a living death. 1 year ago, he walked the streets of Cairo, mad after 30 centuries of living immobility. Today, he rose again, sanity restored, in a New York City museum. Now, without explanation, he is a voyager in an unknown universe, traveling towards a fateful meeting with power times four. And Kantu has absolutely no idea what is happening. Modern man has been taught to look upward, to dream of places beyond. His people were forced to stare down at desert sand, and dream only of death's sweet release. Still, he finds this floating among unfamiliar shapes most pleasurable. The mummy drifts towards one of those shapes, a bright reddish brown ball of earth. Gentle winds caress him. The ground is warm beneath his taped feet. All around him are eye-soothing colors. For a moment, Ankantu thinks he has gone to a better place. Then the earth moves and monsters appear.
I know not how I came here, but the intention of these beings is clear. They intend to attack.
It begins. Bandage wrapped, centuries hardened hand. It digs deep diverts in earth flesh. But the creatures still come on. They're on him then, grasping, clawing, pulling. The mummy wonders why he was taken from the metropolis in which he had awakened. He wonders why the seeming paradise has proved instead to be a hell. And his mind screams out,
"What madness is this?"
But Ankantu does not yield. As warrior, he never yielded. As living mummy, he can do no less. But there is regret as Ankantu battles. Regret that his life has devolved into a series of violent episodes of always striking out. First, against a shipping crate that had carried him from the jail. Followed, in short order, by the door of the Egyptology room, the main entrance of the museum, Central Park muggers, and finally, the police. The mummy remembers the police, the ones with the metal pellets. The bullets that raised new welts on his already ravaged form and brought pain. Pain so intense that even his mighty chieftain will endure it no longer, and fled toward an escape route, which turned out to be a blind alley. That's when the light struck him. That's when Ankantu vanished, leaving behind a staggered constabulary. That's when the mummy came to the weird world, where the very ground rose up against him and threatens to do so again.
Dust demons, like those I sometimes saw swirl across the desert while I worked on the Pharaoh's temple. But these winds seem to have direction, purpose. They lift creatures rise again, and I am too weary to battle them. But the chief of the Swahili never surrenders. Nephrus!
Nephrus, the high priest who doomed Enkantu. Nephrus, a meaningless cry of anguish. Or something more, we shall see. But not until after stiff clay hands have taken Enkantu to a timeless castle, where he slowly regains consciousness and opens his eyes. The palace of gods. Perhaps not gods exactly, but what else could a mortal being call them? Hydron, lord of the waters. Magnum, master of the earth. Hellfire, wielder of flame. Zephyr, mistress of the winds. Small wonder, then, that the mummy refuses to believe what he sees, until...
You seem puzzled, my friend. Speak to us of your doubts and your wishes. We will understand your words.
Does he ridicule me? My voice is no more than a croaking noise coming from a throat dried by centuries. Yet, I am Enkantu, once a chieftain, now the creature you see.
We know that, you poor tortured man. Why do you think we brought you here?
We can help you, Enkantu.
You do understand my words, but how? And how can you help me?
Friend, few things are beyond. The elementals. We made our presence felt on Earth before the sinking of Atlantis. Indeed, before Atlantis was even built. Cast out of one universe, we carved ourselves a kingdom on your world. And because we forehead mastered the forces of nature, none opposed our will. Until we sought to extend our domain to the land that would be known as Egypt. A young warrior, Dan, refused to submit to our rule and plotted against us. With the wizard, Garrett, they joined their two souls to Vapor's arcane and created a ruby gem. Shaped like a scarab it was, a lowly bug. Yet in the hand of Dan, it became a fearsome weapon, sapping our powers and banishing us to this world. We are ready to return to Earth and take what was ours, but we are wary. Mankind has learned, to some small extent, to harness the elements. Two, the ruby still exists, its power intact.
Your words are a task you will set for me. Earlier, you said you would aid me.
Hellfire always did talk around the point. We want you to obtain the scarab for us.
Once we need fear it no longer.
You will return to Earth and attempt to subjugate all mankind. You expect my help in accomplishing your evil designs.
We do, friend, once we have told you that the scarab can make you a living man again.
Memory of cracked, withered, blistered flesh. Struggle as Enkantu thinks what it will mean to be once more a man. A man. Image of a chieftain in a land where men and beasts roam free. Decision made and never to be regretted.
Now, though I spend eternity in my present hideous form, never will I help you enslave a single being. That part of Enkantu ever remains unchanged.
Hydron would kill you, you know. Without one moment's pause, but I would rather persuade you to join us freely, or perish in the fury of my flames.
The flames have not yet burnt through these wrappings, but I must put them out before they consume my dried flesh.
The mummy still stands! At him, Magnum!
Young fool! You rush in unprepared while you shout!
Give me ample time to prepare for his rash charge!
It is more fitting that you fall before me, my bandaged foe.
Zephyr is both elemental fury and woman.
For all men must crumple into earth sooner or later, and I am master of the earth.
As such, she knows many secrets. As woman, she knows how to reach a man's soul. As elemental, she knows how to strip it bare, expose it to her winds of change, and make that soul her own.
I could have taken him, Zephyr.
We require a living slave.
Slave. The word cuts through Enkantu, but he is helpless.
Quite right, my dear. Now, if you will bring our friend to the viewing screen, I will give him his orders. The scarab lies within that seemingly ordinary pyramid. It is currently being studied by a Professor Abdul, but not for long, I am afraid. You will find the scarab and take it from him. Even if you have to kill him, it makes little difference to us. Let's get on with it, Hellfire.
We can't risk this, Abdol, learning the scarab's secrets.
Time could be important, Hellfire.
Very well then. Concentrate, my fellow elementals. Concentrate on
Egypt.
Dr. Scarab, can you be sure?
Ron, Janice, don't ask me how I know Encanto is in Egypt. I heard him call out the name of my ancestor, as if my mind had some sort of link with his. I don't understand all the psychic impressions, but I know he's in or heading to Egypt, and that's where I'm going to.
This desert is a most familiar and unpleasant sight for Encanto. Here, his people built a temple for Aramset. Here they died shackled, that one man's mad dream might come to life. He does not like returning here. But his will is not his own. The spirit of Encanto has been subdued, and it is a living mummy who stalks the seething sands.
What is the coldness that comes over me? I feel as though I were not alone.
He does not want to harm this god, but the wind goddess cannot be disobeyed. The mummy moves forward, ready to strike, ready to kill.
Who goes the... No! No!
Hey Nerdians, thanks for watching the video. We only covered a single issue in this video, but if you want to see how the story unfolds in the next issue, let me know down in the comment section below. Question of the day, what do you think of the Elementals? Are they really Hydro Man, Molten Man and Sandman? Or are they really the Elementals? Comment your speculations down below. Don't forget to check out the show notes in the description below and find out our best picks for Spider-Man merch on Amazon. And if you like our way of explaining comic book issues, then don't forget to subscribe to our channel. This will help us to remain motivated and make more such awesome videos like this, each and every week. Lastly, if you want to remain up to date to the comic book world, then don't forget to check out our Facebook and Instagram pages. We post the latest news and memes almost every day. I'll also add the links to the pages down in the description below.